So I originally planned on making this video when I hit 100,000 subscribers, but, well, I'm a little late on that one, so I figured the beginning of an entire new decade would be a great time to do a Draw My Life. I also apologize because the first half of this is definitely going to be a little sad, but I promise it'll cheer up near the middle of the video. So my story starts out on January 28th, 1997, where I was born in Jacksonville, Florida, to my mom and my dad. I was, well, a baby, nothing too crazy. I wasn't super heavy or super tiny, I was just a normal baby, or so my mom and dad thought. You see, it turned out that I was born with something called a cataract in my left eye, and for the people who don't know what a cataract is, it's basically a condition where the lens in your eye becomes cloudy and, well, you can't see. It's actually a very common thing, and a lot of people over the age of 50 have them, and it's honestly not really a big deal, at least not anymore. The issue, however, is that they're not supposed to happen right when you're born. It's something that can happen naturally over the course of your life, but it's very, very, very rare when it happens to a baby. And as a result, this turned out to be a pretty big deal. Normally, when you have a cataract, eye doctors will do surgery and just replace the lens with a new one, and after a day or so of rest, you're back to normal. When you're a baby, however, they can't just replace the lens as your eyeball is still super tiny, you know, because you're a baby. So I had to have eye surgery on my left eye when I was just 2 or 3 weeks old. I honestly don't remember exactly when, it was a long time ago, but I was literally just days old at the time. So a bunch of eye doctors did surgery and removed the cataract out of my left eye. They were worried I'd be completely blind in my left eye as a result, but luckily I'm not completely anyway. I'll talk more about that later. So I came home after surgery, and except for my left eye, everything was pretty normal. I was a normal baby, I ate, I slept, I used the bathroom a lot, and everything was pretty simple. I lived in a small town in North Florida called McClinney, and when I say small, I mean small. There was literally only a few thousand people living there when I was a kid, and even to this day, there's only just over 6,000 people who live there now. So yeah, it's a very small town. In fact, the biggest store we have there is Walmart, and even then, it's not one of those big Walmarts, it's just a normal-sized one. It's one of those towns where everyone kind of knows everyone, and anytime you go to the store, your parents are gonna run into like 50 different people they went to school with, and so you end up spending 5 hours at Walmart because your parents are talking with old friends, but, you know, it was a nice, quiet town. My family, however, was actually quite large. On my side of the family, we had my grandma and grandpa, and then their children had children, and then their children had children. So I ended up with like 15 plus cousins. And since I didn't have any brothers or sisters, I ended up spending a lot of time with my cousins, which I haven't mentioned yet, but they're literally all girls. I'm actually the only young boy in my entire family, but we'll talk more about my family in a bit. A few years after I was born though, my mom and dad ended up getting into a lot of fights. I don't really know the full story of it all, but I do know it was because my dad started drinking a lot. He started out small, but as time went on, his drinking problems got worse and worse and worse, to the point where he wasn't even the same person anymore. He changed completely. I was only about 3 or 4 at the time, but, you know, my mom, she left. She wanted a divorce. And since it wasn't safe for me to stay with my dad, my mom took me, and then my mom and I went to go live with my grandma and grandpa. And it was really hard at first, you know, my mom had literally nothing. Everything we had was back at my dad's house, and so she pretty much had to rebuild our entire lives from scratch. My grandma and grandpa helped out a lot, and eventually my mom and I did end up getting our own place, literally just down the street from my grandma and grandpa, which, you know, was nice. My dad, however, ended up getting worse and worse and worse, and once the divorce was final, things got really bad for him. He ended up getting arrested, and after a few years, just up and left, and I've never seen him since. I don't know where he is or what he's doing, and honestly, I really don't care, as the whole situation with my mom and dad helped make me into the person I am today, so yeah, it sucks, but I mean, hey, that's life, so you gotta make the best of it, right? Growing up was pretty great though. Like I mentioned before, I was and well, still am pretty close with the rest of my family, and they're honestly pretty great, and I couldn't really wish for a better family. Even though my cousins were all girls, we ended up growing up together and doing a lot of things together. My grandma would babysit us all after school and during the summer, so I ended up spending a lot of time with my grandma and grandpa, along with most of my other cousins too. We mostly spent our time playing outside in the woods, eating Pop-Tarts, or playing the old NES console that my grandma had. And I had a fun childhood, even if I was forced into watching Hannah Montana and Barbie cartoons 24/7. Eventually, though, I turned 5 and, just like all of you, ended up getting enrolled in public school. And so off to kindergarten I went every single day. As far as school went, though, I loved it. I made a lot of friends there and was always one of the top students in the class. I loved reading books and writing stories and even ended up with a super high reading level due to all the books I read. I was definitely that one nerdy kid with the big glasses that just read books 24/7. And to top it all off, my aunt worked at the school too, so if I ever needed anything, she was always just a few hallways away. And if any of you guys have family members that works at your school, you know that all the teachers go easy on you because of it, so yeah, it was pretty great. One of the big issues though throughout school and growing up was that I couldn't really do many physical activities. Because you see, in fourth grade, as a result of the cataract I had in my left eye when I was born, my retina actually detached in my left eye. And for the people that don't know what your retina is, it's basically the back wall of your entire eyeball, meaning without it being properly attached, you can't see at all. So my eye doctors had to do emergency surgery and ended up having to put a giant metal buckle around the back of my eye. It's basically like a belt that just goes around my eye to keep my retina attached and working properly. This buckle will cause my eye to be a weird shape though. It's not a perfect sphere like most eyeballs are. And so as a result, I've never been able to get another lens put into my left eye. And so for the people curious, my natural eyesight in my left eye is 20/200, which actually qualifies as legally blind. I can still see out of it, but it just looks like you're looking out of an unfocused camera. Contacts help a bit with this, but you know, I hate wearing contacts, so I usually just roll without them. As a result of the retina surgery though, and because of the risk of my retina detaching again, I couldn't and can't partake in any super physical activities. That means no sports, no football, no soccer, no anything super physical really. So I did what any kid would do, and I ended up playing a lot of video games. If I couldn't be a super buff guy in real life, scoring touchdowns and getting all the hot babes, then I would just do it inside of a video game. My favorite video game growing up was actually The Legend of Zelda Wind Waker. And well, pretty much all the Zelda games, really. I had a GameCube. I played all of them, and I loved them. I'd come home from school and play them all night, over and over and over again. There was always something new to find or unlock, and I just loved the challenge of them. In fifth grade, however, as I was walking back to class one day, I laid eyes on this one super cute girl. Like, at the time, I felt like I hit the high score in Mario. And since I was a nerdy, quiet kid, there was no way I'd ever have the guts to actually talk to her, or ask for her number for that matter, or anything. But it just so happened that her neighbor, the kid that lived right next door to her, he was in my class. So I ended up coming up with a plan. I was going to become friends with her next door neighbor. We'll call him Corey. And then Corey would set me up with his neighbor. Unfortunately though, the end of the school year was almost here, and literally in just a few days, so we had to improvise. Corey told me to buy an Xbox 360, which had just come out that year, and to add him on Xbox Live over the summer once I got it. And then we could talk over Xbox Live during the summer and come up with a plan to make his neighbor my girlfriend. Unfortunately, since my mom was a single mom and we didn't have much money, that meant I was going to have to work for it. So I spent the first half of the summer mowing as many lawns as I could, washing as many cars as I could, and making money here and there, whichever way was possible. Eventually, I had enough money to buy an Xbox 360, and oh my gosh, that was the best purchase I have ever made. It literally changed my life. I spent the rest of the summer and the entirety of middle school just playing Call of Duty and Halo 3, and boy, was it great. I made so many friends on Xbox Live and created so many memories coming home from school each day, and then just staying up all night, playing online with my friends. It was great. Unfortunately though, my plan to get with Corey's neighbor didn't work out, as turns out she didn't like me, and no amount of blowing kisses at her at school the next year was going to change that, but that was okay, because I had all I needed in life, friends and online video games. As middle school went on though, and as gaming took over my life, I stayed friends with Corey and ended up becoming best friends with his best friends too. We'll call them Luke and Kyle. They were big gaming nerds too, and we all got along great. We'd stay up every summer night playing everything from Halo 3 to World of Warcraft and even Minecraft once that came out. I remember everyone told me I'd regret spending so much time playing video games once I was older, but to be honest, I don't. Those days were the best days of my life, and I really miss when the biggest worry in life was the math test I had on Friday. Because when you're an adult, everything is so complicated and it's not as simple as you just going to school and then coming home and playing video games and repeating the process every single day of your life. At the end of middle school, though, everything changed again. I had to have another eye surgery that ended up keeping me out of school for the back half of seventh grade. And at the same time, my aunt, who I mentioned before, the one that worked at the school, well, she was diagnosed with cancer. And so she ended up retiring so she could stay home and get treatments. And at the same time, since I had already missed an entire half year of going to school, I didn't really want to go back. I ended up enrolling in online high school, which for the people unaware is literally just an online high school. It works the same way. You have your classwork, your homework, your tests, your class meetings, etc. The only difference is it's completely online and you can do it all from your bedroom. And it was great. There I was able to take a bunch of computer classes and programming classes that my original school didn't offer. So I was able to get ahead and really work at my own pace, which helped me complete a lot of my college classes before I even finished high school. I even graduated too with a near perfect GPA. Unfortunately though, a few years after my aunt was diagnosed with cancer and while I was in high school, she ended up passing away. And it hit the entire family pretty hard. For a long time, nothing was really ever the same. My family and I, we were all very close and nothing like this had ever happened before. And so as a kid growing up, this really affected me. The concept of mortality and suddenly not being here anymore, it really scared me. And this whole situation really changed my views and outlook on almost everything. I remember my entire family always told my cousins and I that, everything was just going to be fine. She was going to be fine, and so I was confident. I wasn't worried, and she was fine. She was doing great for a very long time until one day she wasn't. And I bring this up not because it's sad, but because it really changed the way I think. I stopped relying on what other people said and started to become more independent, think for myself, come up with my own views on everything and my own goals and aspirations. And it was then that I decided I was going to stay in online school and become a programmer. You see, up until this point, I really missed school. I missed actually seeing my friends, talking to them before school started each morning. And, I missed not really being lonely all the time. Doing online school is great, and I don't regret it, but since I didn't have a lot of friends to begin with, ones that weren't online anyway, most of my time was just spent in my bedroom doing schoolwork and playing video games, and I was lonely a lot of the time, and a lot of time it made me pretty sad too. I was changing, my family was changing, my life was changing, everything was now different than how it was when I was growing up. So in order to feel like I was actually doing something and to feel productive, along with to learn more about computers, I decided to start making YouTube videos. I was 14 at the time, and I remember my first YouTube video was me building a wooden house in Minecraft. I remember my mom watched it and thought it was kind of boring, and she didn't really like that you were able to hurt the pigs in Minecraft. But, it's Minecraft, so you gotta hurt the pigs in order to eat and survive. It's just how the game works. But I made the video, and I made a lot of videos. And, they were all actually really bad quality at first. But after a year or so of randomly making YouTube videos, I decided that I wanted to start taking these videos seriously. I wanted to make videos on Minecraft mods, how to use them, how to download them, how to install them, everything. So I did. And for the next few years, my life consisted of online high school, video games, and Minecraft mod videos on YouTube. And eventually, though, at the end of 2015, one of my Minecraft mod videos actually went viral. And as a result, YouTube actually assigned me a partner manager, which is basically just someone that can answer questions you have about YouTube if you ever have questions about YouTube. And oh boy, do I have questions about YouTube. But anyway, my partner manager suggested that I start streaming Minecraft, as YouTube gaming had just launched and, I might find success in streaming. I didn't at first, mainly because I was really scared of being live in front of potentially hundreds of people. And also because I was very insecure about a lot of things. My eye, my looks, my bedroom, which was quite small, and everything. I was afraid people would make fun of me and call me ugly or say something mean to me. The other big reason was, basically because I was very antisocial. I was and am an introvert. I don't like being in social situations and I don't like being around a lot of people. It makes me uncomfortable. And so I was really scared to start streaming. I eventually did though, and oh my gosh, it changed my life forever. For some reason, people found me really entertaining, and people loved watching me play Minecraft for hours and hours on end. And I loved it too. I got to interact with a lot of different people from all over the world. I, made a lot of really amazing friends, and I got to do a lot of things that I would have been too afraid to do before. And this was also around the time that Roblox started getting really popular. And after a while of streaming Minecraft, a lot of people asked me to also play Roblox. And at first, I thought it was some stupid kid's game that I would never play in a million years, but, I was wrong. And so I started playing Roblox, and everything really took off from there. Eventually, though, Roblox had this giant event called the Ready Player One event, which was a giant month-long scavenger hunt that Roblox did based on the Ready Player One movie. I streamed it and hunted down clues in the scavenger hunt for almost 5 hours every single day of the month. It really catapulted my channel into the Roblox community, and it's also where I met my fiance Kayla. And if you would have told me 5 years ago that my career would revolve around robbing banks in a Roblox game, and that I'd meet my fiance playing Roblox, I would have told you you're crazy. Yeah, here we are. Today, though, is January 1st, 2020. I've been alive for 2 full decades now, and today is the start of a new decade. My life up to this point has been a bag full of ups and downs, but at this single moment in time, my life really couldn't be any better. I play video games for a living, I'm going to college to learn programming, and I have an amazing girlfriend. I've been able to do some incredible things in my 22 years alive, things that not many people get to do in an entire lifetime, and I'm very thankful for everything. My single greatest wish as a kid was to change the world someday. And up until this point, I always envisioned changing the world as pulling off some incredible feat that changes society in some big way, one giant action that everyone would remember and that would go down in history books forever. But I think I was wrong. Changing the world doesn't have to be about some giant action that makes the world stop and stare in disbelief. It can just be as simple as making entertaining videos that make people happy. Because there's a lot of really bad stuff in the world right now. There's a lot of unhappiness, a lot of sadness, and it gets really hard sometimes for a lot of people. And I think by just being able to make people happy or even take their mind off the sadness, even if it's just for 10 minutes every day, I think that goes a long way. And I'm thankful and proud that I have the opportunity to do that. So that's my plan for this decade. Keep making videos, keep making people happy, and hopefully I can inspire others to do the same.